Hi everyone, my name is Wolverleader. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect, and I'd like to welcome you to this first video in this series on learning the Rust language. Rust is an open source systems programming language that we can use to build efficient and safe software. With Rust, we can manage memory and control other low-level details, but we can also take advantage of concepts like iterations and interfaces, which sets it apart from other languages like C and C++. In this video, we'll talk about what Rust is and why we should use it. We'll also talk about why we might use Rust for particular applications. Then we'll install all the tools we need to use Rust and write and compile a basic Hello World application using Rust. So what is Rust? Rust is an open source systems programming language that you can use to develop efficient and safe software. With Rust, you can manage memory and control other low-level details, but also take advantage of high-level concepts like iteration and interfaces, which set it apart from low-level languages such as C and C++. Now, Rust offers the following advantages that make it a great fit for a wide range of applications. It's type safe, so the compiler assures that no operations will be applied to a variable of a wrong type. It's also memory safe, so Rust has pointers, also known as references, which always refer to valid memory. It's data race free, so Rust borrow checker guarantees thread safety by ensuring that multiple parts of a program can't mutate the same value at the same time. There are zero cost abstractions, so Rust allows the use of high-level concepts like iteration, interfaces, and functional programming with minimal to no performance costs. This performs well as if you wrote the underlying code by hand. There's also a minimal runtime. So Rust has a minimal and optimal runtime. It has no garbage collector to manage memory efficiently. So in this way, Rust is very similar to languages like C and C++. And Rust targets bare metal. So Rust can target embedded and bare metal programming, making it suitable to write an operating system kernel or device drivers. Now, the Rust language has many strengths that we need to consider when choosing the best language for our particular project. So Rust allows for control over the performance and resource consumption of programs and libraries written in the language on par with C and C++, while still being memory safe by default. This level of control eliminates entire classes of common bugs that we might introduce with other languages. Rust also has a rich abstraction features that allow developers to encode many of the invariants of their program into code. This code is then checked by the compiler instead of relying on convention or documentation. This feature can often lead to the feeling of, if it compiles, then it's going to work. Rust also has built-in tools for building, testing, documenting, and sharing code, as well as having a rich ecosystem of third-party tools and libraries. These tools can make some tasks that are difficult in some languages, such as building dependencies, easy and productive to do using Rust. So let's jump into a demo and start our Rust learning journey. We'll start our learning by installing the tools that we need to use Rust, and we'll also write our first program in Rust and run it to make sure we've installed everything correctly. Okay, here I am in Visual Studio Code. Now we're going to be writing all of our Rust code using Visual Studio Code. You can use text editors, any text editor you like. You can even use Notepad if you really want, but I'm going to be using Visual Studio Code for all of these videos. Now, the first thing we need to do, or the first thing that Rust requires, is Microsoft C++ build tools for Visual Studio 2013 or later. And we're going to need to install this before we can install Rust. So to get those build tools, what we need to do is navigate to this web page here. It's Microsoft C++ build tools. You can just search for this in Google. I'll leave a link in the description below. But once you've downloaded that, which I've already done, this will essentially take you to this. So this is the Visual Studio build tools for 2022. And what we need to do now is in this installer window, we just click on this desktop and mobile section here and desktop development with C++ tools. So what we can do, these will just install the C++ build tools that we need to use for Rust. So what I can do is just click install there. Cool. So that's installed successfully for me. I'm not sure why it's changed my theme, but it's pretty cool. Pretty cool side effect, whatever. But now that the build tools have been successfully installed, we can actually go ahead and install Rust. So the recommended way to install Rust is to use RustUp, which is the RustUp toolchain installer. So to do that, what we need to do is head along to this website, rustup.rs, and we're going to find instructions for our appropriate operating system. So I'm running this on Windows. So what I'm going to do is just I'm going to go ahead and download this executable and then follow the on-screen instructions. So let's go ahead and do that. Cool. So that's going to go ahead and open up a terminal for me. So it's saying that a cargo home directory is located at this directory location. This can be modified with the cargo home environment. I'll talk a little bit about what cargo is when we start actually writing some Rust code. I'm going to just go ahead and install the current installation options. So I'm just going to press enter. Looks like I can customize it, or I can even cancel it. And that's going to go ahead and download Rust for me. Cool. And that's installed Rust for me. Fantastic. So if I press enter, and what I'm going to do, I've got a terminal open. Actually close that and reopen it. Navigate to the directory that I'm going to write all my code in. Don't necessarily have to, but what I'm doing now is I'm going to just check the Rust installation to make sure that it's going to be available for me to use. So we should have the Rust C and the cargo commands available to us. So I'll test Rust C first, just by doing Rust C version. And yep, looks like it has been installed. So now I can go ahead and check cargo. And fantastic, those have both been installed. Sweet, so now we have everything we need to start writing some Rust code. So what I'm gonna do is gonna go into Visual Studio Code. And what I'm going to do, I've got this directory open here, Learn Rust. This is a GitHub repository where I'm going to store all the code, and I'll make that available in the description below. But I'll start off by creating a new folder, Hello World, and I'll create a main.rs file there. That's going to indicate that this is a Rust file. So what we're going to do, we're going to write a very simple Hello World program. So I'm just going to go print line hello world, add a semicolon there. Fantastic. Cool. So now what I'm going to do, I'm going to open up my terminal, go into that directory and go rust c main.rs. What that's going to do, if I go back to Visual Studio Code, is that's going to create an executable for us, which we can then run. It's gonna say, hello world, fantastic. Cool, so we've just created our first program in Rust. It's not very sophisticated or smart, but it's cool. You know, we've got something going, which is fantastic. So now what we're gonna do is we're gonna use something called cargo to write and run the same program. Now what cargo is, a dependency manager and a Rust build tool. And most projects actually use this. And cargo does a lot of things for us. We can actually create new project templates with it. We can build a project with it. We can build and run projects with cargo. We can test, check project types, build documentation for it, publish libraries, add dependent crates to a project. And I'll cover what crates are in future videos. But we can do all these things with cargo. So it's a good idea to actually get a handle on what cargo is now and start to create projects with it. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to clear this space. I'm going to create a new project by writing cargo new hello cargo. Got to press enter there. Cool. And what that should have done for us is generate a new directory called Hello Cargo, which we're in right now. So if I ls that, I can see there's a source file in there. There's a TOML file there. That TOML file is essentially a manifest file for Rust, and it's where we're going to keep our main metadata for our project and also keep track of any dependencies. And then in that source file, if I ls into that, that's going to be our code where we're going to, well, our Rust file where we're going to write our application code. So if I actually go back into Visual Studio, what I'm going to do is just open that up. And if I open up that RS file, there we go. It's Hello World again. So it's essentially the same program as we've written before. So if I go back into the terminal there, I am going to just go back into that Hello Cargo directory, and I'm going to write cargo run. So there we go. There's some output. So what Cargo has done here, it's built and executed our executable. So that's just kind of scaffolded a Hello World project for us, which is pretty cool. All right, so that wraps up this video. So in this video, we discuss what Rust is and in what situations we might use Rust. And then we also installed the tools that we need to start writing Rust code, as well as writing our first Rust program by hand, and also initializing our first Rust project with Cargo. If you like this video, give it a like. And if you want to keep track of all the Rust videos that I'm going to be doing, please hit that subscribe button so you can keep track of all the Rust videos that I'm going to be doing in the future. If you have any questions or if you encounter any problems while installing the tools, I ran this on a Windows machine. So depending on whether you're using Mac or Linux, the installation instructions may be a little different. But if you do have any questions, please pop them in the comment section below. No matter where you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.